The iPhone 16 and 16 Pro are officially out, and as we do every year, we have spent the last few weeks living with these phones, testing them out in the wild, and trying to figure out if they are worth upgrading to.
Mike's got the iPhone 16, I've got the 16 Pro, so let's work it out.
So let's talk about the designs of these phones.
One of the newest things on the iPhone 16 that wasn't there on the iPhone 15, this little boy right here. It's called the action button.
The action button that debuted on the 15 Pro and 15 Pro Max last year is now on the standard 16 and 16 Plus. And instead of the ring silent switch that's been around forever, you just get a fully programmable button that you could have do pretty much whatever you want. You can still have it be a ring silent switch. You could have it turn your flashlight on. You could have it Shazam a song, which I have it set up for right now.
If you're a tinkerer like me, you create a menu with about 10 different things that you like to do frequently.
It's a progression we've seen with the standard iPhones for the past 2 years, where they kind of get the big Pro feature from the previous year. It's closing the gap between the standard iPhones and the Pros more and more, and that continues with the other big button.
Just one click of the camera control right here, which is right below the lock button, one click opens your camera, and a little click gets you straight to the camera. Second click takes a photo. And what else can you do with the camera control?
Yeah, you hold it down, you take a video, and it just records as long as you're holding down. I don't love that feature, but that's a story for another day. But if you want to get more granular and almost kind of use your phone as a mini point and shoot, you can do a light double tap, which then brings up this menu where you could customize the zoom, what cameras you're using, photographic styles, the tone. You have all this control, all without taking your finger off the shutter button, which I feel like for the real, you know, iPhone camera enthusiasts out there is a nice little feature.
My thing about the camera control, you can have it zoom in on a much more granular, like 0.5, 0.7, or you can actually just jump through the optical zooms.
The iPhone 16, standard iPhone 16, this thing takes incredible photos. So you finally get macro mode in a standard iPhone, which is kind of, you know, uses that ultra wide lens to get extra detail. But this is not the phone to get if you care about zoom. The 16 gets very blurry very fast once you start going pretty much from 5x to 10x, which is, I think, where it maxes out with digital zoom.
The cool thing is with the 16 Pro and Pro Max I reviewed this year, now both phones have the same telephoto 5x zoom. If you want a different size phone, you should be able to get all the same features. And Apple's gotten pretty close this year. Our battery test, which is a looping 4K video at 50% brightness, shows that bigger does last longer. Apple's smaller phones, around 4 hours or so, have a little bit less endurance on our battery test. And Apple's done some engineering for efficiency of power usage. So this year, not only are the phones gonna last a little longer, but those like me are gonna get a little bit more juice out of their giant phone.
They were all, you know, decently improved over last year's models in terms of battery life. Obviously, the Max is going to get you the most.
While the 15 Pro Max got pretty hot when I take a bunch of photos, like we were at a unnamed press event this morning, and I took more photos than one person probably ever could think to, the phone gets pretty warm in the hand. And that's why I was excited when Apple sort of revealed that it had updated the thermal ingenuity of the 16 Pros. And so when I was testing these, happy to feel it get a little less hot, notably.
That's a big deal. I held your phone this morning. We were tag teaming this event. We were trading, you know, taking photos, trading the phone back and forth. It hurt to hold that thing.
I think you experienced a little bit of warmth when you were playing video games on these phones.
Yes, which is a great segue to performance. I think that's one of the most significant things to talk about on these phones, because it's one of those areas where, in my opinion, the gap is really closing more than ever. You've got A18 Pro in there, you've got standard A18 in here. One of the really significant things is that the A18 in the standard iPhone 16 and 16 Pro lets you play those kinds of big AAA games that were once exclusive to the Pros, so stuff like Resident Evil Village, Resident Evil 4. Yeah, it didn't look quite as crisp as it did on the PS5. There were a handful of moments where things got a little slow, but the fact that I was still playing a high-fidelity AAA game on, you know, Apple's base-level phone, an iPhone's not gonna replace your console, not gonna replace your PC, the Mac isn't even there yet, but just having the option to try out some AAA games without owning a console, I think is a win, so.
Impressive.
Yeah.
If we had to throw out the last 3 minutes of that video and we were to say, what's the A18 chip? It's impressive. The 4 spatial microphones in the Pro phones and the A18 Pro chip enables a lot of extra features. And one of those is gonna be with Voice Memo app, right?
This is gonna be exclusive to the 16 Pro series. You're gonna be able to have multi-track voice memos. So as myself and a lot of musicians do, we'll lay down a quick song idea, quick demo on our voice memos. You'll be able to record over that track. Maybe you want to record vocals over a guitar or a vocal harmony over existing vocals. It's a small thing, but for a certain subset of people, including me, like, it's a big deal. And it's one of those things where, as someone who's still deciding if they're going to get one of these phones, like, that could be one of the things that sways me.
If you love your video and you really want to, like, be an amateur Spielberg or Nolan or Gerwig, you can record it 4K 120 FPS on this bad boy, and you can slow down the frames per second for super slow-mo back and forth after you shoot.
Yeah, the 4K 120 stuff is exclusive to the Pros, but what you'll get on both phones is the audio mix feature, which is pretty wild. It basically lets you record a video and then alter the audio mix after the fact. This is a feature I kept forgetting I had, and I was just opening up videos that I happened to record, and I was like, oh, here's band practice. And I turned on cinematic mode, and suddenly I could hear my entire band way better than before. One of my biggest criticisms of the Pro line is also one of my favorite things about the standard iPhones, and that's that, you know, the base iPhones, as always, come in a great suite of colors. We've got the teal and the white. There's also a gorgeous ultramarine, like Henry said. It's like a deep blue. There's a pink option for those who are still living their barbiecore summer. It never ended. Tell me about the Pro colors, which seem a lot more understated.
Apple will call this natural titanium, and I will say no, this is silver. Because titanium is the material, and the naming structure for Apple's Pro phones is adjective titanium, desert titanium, because it has a bronzish, copperish band.
Yeah, it's exactly how the desert looks.
You know, I remember that from John Wick 4 or John Wick 3, I'm not sure. It is what it is. As I wrote in my review, I challenge Apple to make a truly colorful and impressive titanium iPhone next year. And that's part of the reason why I don't want to switch away from my 15 Pro Max, which is in this like really nice blue. It's understated, but it's like, it has a lot more color than these things. Like, if you don't want to use a case, your phone color matters to you. Or if you want to use a clear case.
Yes.
And so those of us who do that, it just feels like we're paying more to get a phone that says less. So we can't talk about phones without talking about the displays. So there's not much that's different here. The Pro Motion on the Pros is better, it's smoother, but it's mostly the same screen stuff as before. These are a little bit larger. That's all you really need to know. So Mike, which phone are you looking at for yourself?
You know, I've been thinking about this a lot. I was so excited for the new phones to come out. I assumed I would just upgrade to a 16 Pro. You know, I'm on a 14 Pro, two years upgrade. I was probably gonna go Max because I want the bigger screen. You know, the stuff like the smoother display, the always on, that's nice. Some of those Pro exclusive audio features are tempting. So me personally, I might actually skip this year or see how long I can go before my 14 Pro completely falls apart. Just because, yeah, there's something about as great as the Pros are, these are incredible smartphones, the 16 Pro, 16 Pro Max. I just don't feel an urgency to go out and buy one. I think it's more about, that's where I am in my iPhone journey right now.
So I'm on the Apple upgrade program, which means what's another year of monthly installments, really? So I'm considering getting the Pro Max just because, a little bit less overheating, hopefully. The photographic styles is the kind of feature that I'm gonna spend like way too much time having fun with. And if you really care about how crisp your photos look when you zoom in, the Pros, one of them, whichever fits your hand best, go for those.
I do think that the standard iPhone 16 and 16 Pro are the best smartphones for most people. The value you get for, you know, starting at $799 for the basic iPhone, this is the most pro a regular iPhone has been. And you take kind of the cameras and a few features out of the equation, these phones have never been more similar, and I think these look better, and it's cheaper. So Definitely, like Henry said, there are going to be people that go towards the Pro, especially when it comes to camera, but I think this phone right here is the best smartphone out right now for most people.
Thank you.